Picking up from where we left off, you arrive at Ale Salon in Kapuki. It is a completely dead town. There is nobody to be seen at all.
Doors. I think we're too late. Shut.
Windows are shuttered up. You know, it's midday, so the sun is high in the sky. Heat waves are going across the ground. There's some like gentle breeze that's just moving some of these sands that are just shifting slowly, but there is no sign of life. But at the end of this street is a large pillared sort of town hall.
Can I make a perception test to see if the buildings appear to be sealed, like the windows boarded, etc.?
Yeah, of course.
Oh, actually, I'm okay at this.
In character, Azazel, would your reasoning for this be to see were they fleeing for something or
I'm
trying
curious.
To stop something?
Yeah, I'm curious as to whether they're hiding. Or you know, if anyone's... I'm just trying to work out if the place is inhabited and just, like, shut down.
Okay.
9.
Okay, yeah, so... Yeah, you approach a door and sort of just put your hand on it, I guess, just to sort of see if, you know, feeling the wood grain and whatnot material, and you can hear muffled movement inside the property, but it's completely closed and shuttered down.
There's movement inside. Does it appear to be sealed from the inside, yeah?
Yeah, it's sealed from the inside.
Okay, I mean, so they seem to have barricaded themselves inside. Whether it's a civilian or something more sinister, I cannot say.
Ghosts?
Sand ghosts.
Okay, so how does the party respond to Azazel's information on this matter?
Push the door down.
I turn around and kick the door in.
You tried to bust the door down.
No.
You didn't. Oh, you didn't just say that. I mean, I'm on the edge. It doesn't take much encouragement. Azazel's
on the cusp of just.
He don't even know, man. He's hair trigger, you know.
I'm gonna get out my. I'm gonna get one of my bolts out. I'm gonna start striking my harp and go. Dink, bring out your dead. Dink. Bring out your dead!
I stride away from the door looking around as the sound
out
echoes
dead.
Out.
As Windows,
worth a try.
As Windows playing this instrument and you're sort of all looking around, you see that the town hall at the end of this street, the bell tower that sits on the top, starts to ring just very sort of just one note, almost counting the time, but it's not, it goes past the time, it rings 17 times.
Oh, I see, it's 17 o'clock. Either that, or that bell tower is wanting a clinking competition. Well, a clinking competition you shall get. Dink, dink.
I just
striking it harder. Dink,
at
dink,
this moment I dink. Reach over my shoulder, drawing my shield and my short sword, and I turn to face the door again, and I shield slam my way through the door. And
okay.
But just before, as I'm turning, I say something is not right here, and then I charge the door.
Of the town hall, or of the...
Of the building which I checked first. One of the smaller buildings.
Okay, so this is one of the small buildings.
Yeah.
So my original plan...
Of course, I mean, I was heading that direction.
Okay, so yeah, roll to see if you break this door down.
Okay, I'm not super strong, but here we go. I'm penalized for athletics, of course. Not a
can
warrior.
Can I assist with my strength?
You can make it worse with your strength. I'm gonna lawyer this. what do I get for hitting it with a shield? I'm running with my full weight with the shield and slamming into the door with a shield.
Well, this is a very large doorway. I'll grant you a plus one for the shield, for putting your full weight into it. But note that if this is a terrible failure, that may have a downside as well.
I'm willing to accept that fact. Yeah, here we go.
Okay, are you?
Nice knowing you.
You sort of charge at the door and try and shield bash this door in, and it you collide with it with an almighty thud, and the thud rains out across this sort of town area, and you bounce off and you just land backwards on the party, like, you know, just completely, you just get a face full of sand, just mouth full of sand.
Yeah, I think I like skid back and the sand's all kicked up.
I stop at her and go, hey, two, Azazel, you trying to outclink me too?
I don't stand a chance. And as I'm getting to my feet, I'm just looking at the door. I'm looking for any sign of, is anything emerging from within in response? What's going on?
Yeah, so muffled from the inside, you just hear voices saying, I think there's something outside. Then you hear another voice that's just like, we need to hide. And then that's it. Like, it goes muffled again, and then it's quiet. There's no more rumbling sounds sounds from inside.
So if it's confirmed that, I mean, these guys, they do I need to roll perception to determine whether they seem more startled or more as if they're like ambushing? Yeah. I mean, it seems unreasonable, that it would be an ambush. But do I at least feel these guys are terrified? Right.
Yeah.
Okay. So. In that case, I stride up to the door again, and I'm like, citizens, fear not, we are from the guild. Tell us what is happening here.
I'm bringing you dead.
And maybe that gives me an assist.
Yeah, roll me a persuasion.
I'm not too charismatic, unfortunately. I seem to be taking the lead as the non-charismatic one. It's all good. Okay. Are you going to make a check to see if I get a bonus window? Looks like it's happening. It's happening. Oh my god, nice. 12.
So you hear sort of some footsteps get closer to the door, and then sort of like what you can imagine is almost like a hand hitting the other side of the door, like a thud. And then you hear a slightly muffled voice, because the thickness of this big sort of like sturdy door. And the voice is just like, if you're from the guild, like you say, please head to the town hall. We really need your help. We can't come outside.
What is happening?
I don't know. I haven't been told. Please, if you head to the town hall, you will find Shari. Shari will be able to tell you. He's a, what would you call it, mayor.
Very well. Remain safe, citizen. And I do exactly as instructed.
Okay, so approaching the town hall door, the door's unlocked. You know, it's slightly ajar, it's not fully closed.
I swing it open wide and walk in.
Okay, so inside, as you all enter, it's really dark, very dark in there. It's, you know, completely, you know, sun shielded for coolness and whatnot.
What was that
There's
name?
No light lit. Shari.
I'm gonna follow. I'm gonna go. I'm blind. Oh wait, it's the darkness. Ah, hello. Clink! Bring out your dead! Oh, what do you want? Clink!
I was about to say something, but that's fine. That's clearly going to arouse suspicion.
Ding ding!
Okay, sort of peering up over where a bunch of these seats are, like in this town hall, this like relatively old tanned gentleman sort of stands up and he's just like, you're here, finally! Please, come!
I immediately respond by approaching him.
He says, "Oh, the guild must have sent you, right?"
"Correct."
"Finally. It has been days. I don't know what has taken you so long."
"I ensured that we arrived as soon as possible."
"It's this thing, it's called walking."
I just don't know how he would respond to that statement. Okay, he looks very, very scared. He's just like, "Please, you must help us. We don't know what to do."
"Okay, details. We cannot make bricks without mortar."
"Tell us exactly how we may aid the town of Aelsalon."
To the northwest of here, there is a small village. It used to be ran over by Samir bandits. However, it has fallen very deathly quiet there. It's over in Rathatar. However, we believe that something very, very bad must have happened. A lot of the creatures of Kapuki have completely disappeared. And the jungle from around Rathatar, which was our native hunting grounds many moons ago, it seems completely deserted.
"My God." And I just like gaze, and there's some horrific images that no one can see playing on my on the backs of my eyes right now.
So let me get this straight. There are no dead?
Dead? No. No, there's no dead. Has somebody died?
No, I'm asking you that.
"Fear not, civilian. Windelar, the case is that there has been a disturbance locally that has prevented any hunting taking place in this region. Surely supplies are running thin here in Aelsalon and across Kapuki. We must restore balance as soon as possible."
"Indeed, yes, there is something very, very strange going on. We do not know what has caused it. We have very little in the way of supplies. However, I will give you provisions to make your journey to Rathatar to find the source of this problem. If you would be so kind as to take this job."
"Not the sound of food. All right. I'm game."
"My friend speaks true."
"We believe that the Samir leader, Thaynarv, is responsible, but we're just completely unable to locate him anywhere."
Thaynarv, you say?
"Yes, he's... with a V at the end, like Thaynarv."
"Thaynarv, okay."
"Yes, with phlegm."
"And he, sorry, is he the, like, elder of this settlement, was that?"
Yeah, Shari's, like, the town elder.
Shari is, Thaynarv is...
Thaynarv is believed to be the leader of the Samir encampment.
Of the Samir encampment.
Ding, 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 ding. "Right, I know the problem. I see what we have here. You people have a ghost town problem."
"Exactly.
Or at if least... this matter is not handled, we shall all perish of famine."
"This will soon be a ghost town if this problem is not handled."
"This town has become a ghost town."
I inquire. Am I speaking with Shari now? Shari? Oh, okay.
Yeah, you're
just to clarify.
Shari.
And Shari is an elderly, sort of desert tanned, wrinkled,
yeah, tanned desert gray haired
Okay. Shari, please equip us with anything you may have to offer immediately, and we shall set to work.
So he turns around and picks up this sort of, well, I imagine to be a big cloth sack, and just sort of throws it on the ground in front of you, and, you know, opening it up, there's, you know, provisions enough for you all for your journey, both to Rathatar and back to Aelsalon. So it's
fantastic.
Two-day journey there, and it's a two-day journey back, so you've got four rations each.
All four rations. Beautiful.
Nice.
To Rathatar!
Shari turns to you all and says, I honestly believe in my heart that Thaynarv is responsible for this. As proof, I want his head just to settle these villagers, because they are extremely, extremely scared."
"Very well. We shall make it so."
"Villages of cats, I see."
The rations are distributed, and I believe we are ready to depart, but we would probably go in the morning, right, guys?
A kipple sound nice.
I do need my beauty sleep.
Let's play it safe then. Okay.
And do we get, like, no one has to go watch, so everyone gets to sleep?
We're in the town, so presumably we can just... In the... What is this building called again?
It's the town hall.
I just knew it had a steeple. Okay, we can use the town hall, presumably.
I assume... Yeah. Well, we should ask him first if he has any lodgings for us before we make the journey in the morrow.
I'm assuming he hooks us up with the town hall, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So we just get comfy for the night. Maybe I partake of the pipe weed to try and sedate myself as to, you know, hold back for the evening.
Fine, I shall split my last day's pipe weed.
Most generous. You shall be repaid for this kind favor, Windar.
Right, me and Windar and Azel sit down smoking a bit of a pipe.
I find something squishy to lay on and curl up in a massive fluffy ball.
Oh, get off me!
Oh, but you're so comfy, Windar!
Perfectly sized as a cushion. So, is the night in Ale Salon relatively safer than the nights we spent in the wilderness traveling here?
There's just nothing. There's no animals or people around. It's for all intents and purposes, it seems dead.
Yeah,
like if you could really picture a dead desert that has a town in it, it's deader than that. Like it's really dead.
It's just some like skeletal remains half buried in the sand here and there and stuff. I like it. Cool.
The lying sons of bitches. They said there was no dead.
No, I believe I was trying to describe animal remains. Yeah. Apologies.
Right. Snooze cruise.
Yes, in the morning. I arise and... Well, I mean, I prepare to depart. Hopefully the horses are watered and rested somewhere. It doesn't seem like that's the case. Maybe we have to go on foot.
There is a horse near the town.
Yeah, there's the oasis, the stables at the oasis and whatnot. They're kept relatively cool.
Should we leave the horses here in Ale Salon?
I'll never leave Horsington behind.
But Vor, and I don't kneel down. No, what would I do? You're bigger than me. I look up at you and maintain rigid eye contact, and I'm like, but Vor, Horsington may be injured. If we are to enter
such... Leave him.
Perilous regions of the world. I mean, I personally fear greatly for Horsington's safety. I understand he is a valued member of... And yeah, ramble on a bit.
Going with you to what you could all possibly picture to be certain death, that's fine. But Horsington, he could get injured. Now he's staying there. you guys can all fucking die in a fire.
Yeah, I mean, what the hell are the following guild members who are sent to their deaths meant to ride upon... into oblivion if Horsey doesn't make it? Come on.
Oh, I'm the type of guy that likes to roam around. I'm never in one place.
So, of course, in true Azazel fashion, I'm standing on the edge of town in the morning, and the sands are just blowing at my ankles, and my huge white cape is billowing in the desert winds.
And then you hear something on the wind. It sounds like, no! And then you hear me go, who said that? Yeah, who said that? It certainly wasn't me who shouted that. Who said that?
And I just remain like my gaze fixed, undistracted, unwavering focus, staring towards Rathatar. Presumably I can see the distant desert through like the heat haze. The distant jungle very far off through the haze.
You can see the scrubland like breaking and like really, really far distant tall trees.
I am ready to depart when my party is.
Everyone think everyone's ready to depart.
I'm saying a heartfelt goodbye to Horsington. Walking away.
As you're joining us, then I look to Cathar and I say, Cathar, use that trusty device of yours with its magnetized properties and lead us forth.
I will.
Do pray tell. I await on bated breath as to your decision.
I'm assuming that we... Nice. We actually do have, like, a map of these basic roads and stuff, right?
Yeah.
So the map that we're seeing is actually the map.
Yeah.
That makes sense. And if we were to get into the wilds, we would need, like, specific maps for that region of the wilderness to actually gain any bonuses.
Yeah, it'd be more difficult in those locations.
How do we fare with a 9?
Go through here.
How do you do?
2 rations shall be subtracted at minimum, so I'll do that now.
Oh, I'm tempted just to allow you to get there in one piece in one go for that beautiful.
Thought you were going to say you were tempted to just kill us all. Tempted to unleash a dragon.
That's the song that we shall ramble to.
Yeah, you guys make it to the forest edge. You kind of just make it. In fact, I'll place the marker. You guys have made it to here just as it starts to become really, really thick, dense forest. Or jungle, should I say.
Well...
With ease.
So 2 days travel brought us to the edge of the forest.
No. It's like a day and a half. You're arriving at the jungle. I basically put it there so I could set the scene for the jungle. Like, sure, you've still got enough provisions to get to continue.
And we have to take, like, a second navigation check because of the terrain change, presumably.
Yes, because of the terrain change. Exactly that, sir.
Cool.
As going through jungle is a 50% penalty for time, so...
In the jungle.
Cathar, do you think you can lead us on into the depths of this...
But maybe someone has a better perception than I do.
Perception is not going to help us. You're still navigating. Yep. Yeah,
we're still
right. It's only me. Yeah.
You're okay, leagues ahead of us.
Oh, instead of a +3, it's a -.
It's the same roll. We move 50% slower.
Yeah, because the times are different now.
Shit. So what he said was going to last us might not last us. Jesus Christ! What?
Feel that jungle boogie.
It definitely does last you. Shadow of a doubt. Make it through there. Like, I mean, Cathar's just walking through there. Like, what jungle? Like,
yeah.
Well, it's not even a jungle here. This is just a path.
Follow that trail.
Well, for me, I might be able to just slip under all the bushes.
Yeah, well, I'm just like clambering over it. You're just walking normally as I'm like tangled up on everything. God.
Okay, yeah,
damn it.
You reach this sort of a tribal settlement. It's just, you know, it's got 2 tents and then a hut. And that's it. There's a campfire that doesn't look like it's been lit in a long time in this forest clearing.
Do I need to roll perception to see if we've spotted animals on the way, or is the jungle just like, it's nothing as well?
No, the jungle is pretty much empty. There's the sound of birds, as you can hear, but it's otherwise empty.
Flying like, creatures are fairly safe. Yeah, okay.
What ho? Is that a foe we spot upon us? Poor bastards, they don't even know how to light a fire. Troglodytes, I tell you, troglodytes.
I would like to examine the campsite, searching for any tracks or... Actually, no. I would like to instruct Vore. I would like to say, Vore, perhaps if you analyze the surrounding terrain, you will find some tracks that may lead us to the source of this desolation.
I'm going to stay in the forest line. You never know. Wouldn't want to get our asses jumped.
Okay.
Leave the task to me.
Very well. And I stride towards the campsite to investigate.
Okay, I'm gonna carefully ready my crossbow.
What sort of roll is that?
Skill check, and it will be a nature check.
Don't forget that you have your trusted book.
Oh yeah, can I use my book?
Wow, the books. Those came in so much more useful than I was ever anticipating. I mean, I knew they'd be good, but damn.
Worth every penny.
For those of you that got a decent gold roll, that man was alright.
It doesn't. Even if you roll like the lowest gold, you should be able to get the adventurer's kit and stuff that you need. You know.
You're having a bad day with these rolls.
Yeah.
Oh man, but oh, six just. But Windelar. Inspirational performance is definitely available once again, and I would recommend providing it to Vore in this scenario.
I think I managed to poke my own eyes out whilst trying to look around.
I mean, two ones, that is an epic fail. I mean,
yeah, it's like, it doesn't matter what those bonuses are, it still doesn't work at all.
Yeah, it's guaranteed to fail. And this
just
is...
looked down, looked up, and shook her head.
This is sure. This is DM discretion. There's no ruling about this. But also, an epic fail could, and some DMs may choose to have something negative happen to us. Let's say.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Just saying. But yeah, I would definitely suggest the reroll from Windelar before, if you would agree, Windelar, your class skill.
Yeah,
Windelar,
your
can you lend your bardiness?
Bard powers activate! Strum! 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 It's like, cat! That feline! That was an appalling attempt! Try again!
It's more of a thing. The way I envision it is that it replaces the original occurrence, if you know what I'm saying. It's a re-roll as opposed to like a... I'm not explaining this well, let's move on.
Okay, Kat, re-roll. Same thing.
Come on, tracks. Tracks on the ground.
Yeah, so you can. So, for you look at the ground and you're able to discern that around the fire, it looks like people have been dancing around this said fire.
Hippies! And then,
the hunter who's like immersed in the wilderness is like dirty hippies dancing around fires.
All of these footsteps and what all these tracks sort of converge and go into this one hut.
I've seen this before. It's a mating ritual, I tell you. A mating ritual.
Perhaps we ought not disturb them. I'm just confused at this point. Like,
so you see tracks going into this hut. There's no tracks coming out of the hut. There's just tracks going into a hut.
Hmm. Yes. And we know these creatures to be extremely dangerous.
Yeah, you believe them to be Samia.
Can we burn the tent down?
Good job we didn't bring a rogue, guys. Man. Well, let's start theory crafting. Okay, so Vore, you have stealth. I'd say you'd be the most equipped to try and determine what's happening on the inside of this thing without being detected.
Okay, I'm gonna go and...
Oh, dex mod too, nice.
Peep through the window and see what I can see.
I back away as quietly as I can towards the tree line. Not to actually know, 100 meters away from the hut.
Is the hut's entrance in my line of sight where I've been hiding?
Yeah, the hut's entrance is relatively large.
Right, yeah, well, I'm just gonna aim my crossbow ready at the entrance.
Just speculating here, but you might be in long. You're probably in long. You might even be exceeding your long range at the tree line. So 100 meters max.
I figured I'd just come in.
Light crossbow.
And did I follow you guys?
You're gonna be fine.
Cannon.
I'd get 150 meters back. Your max range, Cathar.
Cool.
So you just be just behind me a bit. 9. Respectable.
Okay. Yeah. So yeah, you peer through this door and it's completely empty. There's a hatch on the floor that you see that's sort of like down on the ground. And yeah, it's completely empty inside.
Do you signal for us to rejoin you?
Oh, yeah, I'm signalling to come over. I'm waving my massive paw in the air.
What is it for?
There's a hatch. There's no one around. There's a hatch.
We should descend below. And I'm just, like, nodding as if to say, like, I'm agreeing for you. Yes. Descend below.
I vote we send the small one first.
I think I would pick him up by the collar and put him behind me and say, I'm sorry, Vor. That's not going to happen.
I have an idea!
Window.
How about we tie the small one to rope and dangle him down?
Pull me back!
And then if he gives a signal,
2 tugs for Paul, 1 pull for more.
Just pull up like a frayed end of a rope, like, well, there goes the wizard. We fed it to something.
We lower him down, he gives a quick peek. If anything there, we can pull him back out. Simple as! It's like fishing, but without catching things.
Cathar,
you hope that it would be without catching things.
I look to Cathar, recognizing he's an extremely intelligent being, and say, Cathar, if you agree to this plan, I shall not stop you. But should you disagree, I will take the lead.
I do disagree. I was just mocking people.
I'm Coward. Going to descend. By whatever means I see when I throw open the trapdoor. I'm not being stealthy because I'm wearing mail. There's no point.
Why don't we just... Why don't we send a pair of maracas down there? Like...
That's pretty much what we're doing. To distract Worse, them. In fact. We may as well just drop 5 gongs off the...
Tom,
just
Tom,
push
really
them down.
His bard role seriously. He's just got a plethora of instruments.
Just so many instruments. Next week you'll have like an orchestra behind you or something, dressed as a conductor or something.
Okay, so you all descend downwards, down these like ladder type things.
Speak for yourself.
I descend downwards.
Oh, just
alone.
You.
Yes, to scout
just
ahead.
You.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Can I try and kick Cathar down the hatch?
I actually, just to retcon quickly, I ask that a torch is dropped, and then I descend.
Okay.
I'll drop a torch. Just don't lose it. I
descend as soon as the torch is released from the hand.
All right. Fair dues. Let's, Jump ye over.
I'm not pleased about this map change into pitch black darkness.
So yeah, you reach the bottom, it's you know, the torch and
we're not on the world map anymore.
The torch illuminates the space in front of you. And yeah, you can arrive at the bottom.
Do I need to make a perception check to immediately scan my surrounding?
You can do.
That's what I'd be doing. I lost Cathar for a second there. I don't have access to my token, but I can reach it from here.
No. It's what? Your token's on the map. Top right corner, the bit that's visible.
Oh, top right.
Two down. Yeah.
Oh boy, there we go.
I will always be your friend. I'll be watching, guarding you from under your bed.
Just a success, I mean.
Okay, yeah, so you can, it's like this, you're looking at the walls and it's just this, almost like an underground crevasse, like it's this underground cave network that you seem to have lowered yourself into.
Am I hearing anything beyond what I'm hearing through the actual audio?
Yeah, there is more sound. There's echoes coming from deep within this cave. Very animalistic sounds.
Hmm. Okay, normal level, they'll hear me, I just say, follow. It's clear.
Okay, you guys lower down?
Though I hear a presence deeper in the construct.
I'll stay at the back, the rest of them.
I'll step forwards a short distance just to, like, let them file in behind me.
Okay.
Black, empty, nothingness.
Top right corner.
Top right.
Aha.
There you go, your tokens are on.
Horrifying. Oh god, and the music changed. Yeah, this is one of my favorites though. Do you like this one?
I don't think I can see anything. I found it.
Nice. I am going to stride forth, asking. This is a good question. Who would like to be my torchbearer?
I'll do it.
Very good, Vor. Stay with me. I gesture to my shield, and I'm like, I'm overburdened. I cannot carry a light. And I start walking forward, sort of glancing around, looking. You know, I'm on high alert, you might say.
Yeah.
As I progress deeper into the cavern to uncover more of the mysteries that await.
Okay, yeah.
Again, crossbow drawn, I'm going to follow. Be really sort.
So as you turn the corner, you see two peculiar creatures and a giant wolf.
Are we detected?
You are not detected. They aren't. They aren't looking.
Vor,
your
back
direction.
Behind the corner. Shield the light. I whisper, trying to make sure that we stop immediately.
And in the thing, I'll pull these up so you guys can see. There you go. And there is the other creature.
Perhaps you would like to vocalize this for the viewers at home.
Oh, I can vocalize it. So I'll vocalize the Bargeist. So these are the tales of a once famous warrior that you have the booklet of, some of you. So yes, the Bargeist. The Bargeist is a wolf-like creature, the size of a common bull, thick-furred with large, luminous eyes, large canines and oversized paws with truly devastating talon-like claws. On my travels, we could hear the deafening howls and shrieks of one of these beasts. However, my guide said that it was at least 2 kilometers away. The following day, we found it laying dead. We weren't sure what had killed the beast. Some say that the Bargeist is the king of wolves, and that the wolves will protect the Bargeist with their lives. And then we have the Samir.
Nice. I think I'm going to run away screaming and give up adventuring for life.
The Samir are similar to Exfligori, and I believe the two probably share a shared genus. Samir spend their time in marshlands and swamps, and live in wooden built encampments. They are extremely hostile to almost anything that enters their territory, and take pleasure in causing as much pain as possible. Samia stand around 4 feet tall. They have large arms and long legs, and much longer than almost any other hominid I've come across. I came across a group of these Samias inside a cave network. I killed 3, but 2 managed to escape.
Well, I'm horrified. So, I what I would do is I kind of back up against the wall and I'm looking around the corner, and I say, ready your ranged attacks. I shall make the first move. As soon as they detect our presence, release your magics, your arrows, and your bolts. Let us focus on the largest of the creatures. Wait, can I... can we just... Can we slow it down for a second? I would really like Vor to
I'm
make...
I'm also going to have to be in position if these... we want me yeah, to attack, don't we?
Yeah, I don't necessarily know if everyone's got the range, but I'm pretty sure we do. Are these beasts or magical beasts that we would know?
They're beasts. There's the main one's a beast. The Bargeist is a beast. The Samir are hominids. So they're humanoids.
Okay. Humanoids. Interesting. That would be history. I think Cathar was trained in history. No. No, he's not. Okay. So in that case, I think Vor should use the adventuring handbook, which I believe you took, to to identify the beast, the largest of the creatures. Wish we could see the name tags under these just for reference there.
Yeah.
What's, is that a skill check?
Skill check, and let me check here. You've got a plus +2 from the book, and that's it.
Okay.
Excellent. Would she know with this check that that is a... Basically, I'm trying to determine if that creature's more deadly than the other two by a substantial margin.
Okay.
I know they're humanoids and they're not beasts. It wouldn't fall under nature, but maybe with an 11 we can...
Okay. I'm just trying to make sense of some of these tables. Bear with me. Sure. Yeah, you'd see that the Bargeist is more dangerous.
Okay. So after studying it, Vor, you're able to inform us that it is, of course, the focus target.
Yeah.
Presumably your years of hunting.
Just as I'm curious.
I've come across these before. Beasts gone bad. They're very deadly.
Beasts gone bad. That sounds like a porn.
Yeah.
Just out of reference, because I don't want to spend like ages looking through the book, and I want to get right into this. Under the monsters tab, where it's got hit HD, so for example, Bargeist.
It's a D8.
So it's a D8.
Every hit dice that they have is 1D8. If it's half, it's half the result off a D8.
Okay.
So if it's got like 8 hit die, 8D8.
Okay.
Same as a warrior's hit die.
Yeah.
Presumably these are all GM rolls. We're not going to learn a thing, guys. Okay.
Yeah.
And so 70, you kind of want to be in 75 meters. Are you able to achieve that, Windalar? Windar? Do you mind if I say Windalar? I keep saying that.
That's actually Wind...
It's actually the name.
It's actually Windale.
Windale.
It's an old, it's Old Norse. D-A-L-R is pronounced Dale.
But as a character, I don't care. you get part of it right. So I'm like, oh, it'll work.
Okay. I mean, if you ever instructed me to say Windale, I would say Windale.
Yeah, but I haven't. So you can choose to keep calling me Windala.
Sure. As soon as I hear it in conversation, though, I'll
let you do that. That's fine. Cool. Sorry, what you said. I am in position. I'm in 70 meters. I can shoot any of them.
Oh, golden. Wonderful.
Okay, so Vor would know that the Bargeist is more dangerous than the Samir.
Nice. All right, we're absolutely convinced that we're going to focus the Bargeist. I am going to lead the charge. You guys are all ranged, so I'm not even leading a charge. I'm just charging. Here I go.
What's it say,
here I go again on my own.
What I would like to do is I step forwards as quietly as I can, just like two steps, maybe three steps, just gently as not to move my chain. I hold up my shield and I raise my short sword into the air like this, signaling to the party who are behind me. and then I drop the short sword, signaling for all of the magic and arrows to be unleashed as I drop a smite onto the Bargeist.
Okay, so you're all targeting the Bargeist.
Yes.
Yep.
Okay, I've just got to find where this turn order piece has gone. I'm sure it's like in
this is an ambush. We don't even need initiative yet.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just trying to pull it up ready, but I can't.
Okay.
Anywhere for some reason.
Oh, the turn order thing.
Yeah,
should be
yeah,
on your tools list.
Yeah.
Should be down there on there somewhere. I don't see it now because I'm a player, so I can't tell you the icon.
Oh, there we go. Found it. It's fine.
Cool.
All right. Cool. Okay. Yeah. So for those doing damage to the Bargeist, it has an AC of 6. Just to let you all know.
What will you cast, Cathar?
Oh, sorry. It'll be lightning bolt.
Oh, cool. So for me and Cathar, it has to make a magic saving throw versus it, whatever difficulty class it may have. And that will vary depending on how proficient it is at actual magic. I mean, it's a beast, isn't it? So it's going to be bad.
Yeah.
So it's probably a it's probably like a 14 or something high, 14, 15. It's going to be hard for it to succeed. I believe that's a miss from Windelar.
That's what I said, fuck.
Oh, sorry. I missed that.
So I lost the bolt. No!
Vor, please use your special ability. Oh my god.
Oh yeah, I can do true shot. I'm doing true shot!
Oh, thank god. For those who are unaware, the viewers, that was a broken weapon right there. She would have had to restring the bow, and that's a 37! Wait, plus 20.
Oh, wait, wait, you're plus 20.
She almost killed me.
It whistled straight past your ear.
It is still a hit, even at 6.
Do you want to re-roll it, or are you happy to take it with a modifying the...
I'm happy to take it with the modifier, so it's still a hit.
Sure, okay. Wow, if you broke your bow on the first turn of the entire campaign, that would have been... Well, it would have been rough. So, as DM, you've got to make the saving throws for the creature.
Yeah.
So I will subtract a single mana point from myself. Here we go. And where will you allow me to reach, by the way? How close could I have gotten to cast that smite?
You can get to 50, fine. So there.
Thank you.
Yeah, I roll a 1d20 and basically if it's...
There is a save macro, yeah.
Oh shit, there is, yeah.
It'll be against like a whatever you choose, something 14, 15-ish, something not great. I would assume.
There you
was
go.
That for me or Luke?
I shall roll one for Luke now.
Okay. Nice, dude. I unleash 1d6 plus wisdom, and in my case, that's a plus
and
one.
And I do 1d6 plus intelligence, which in my case is... Oh, God, I'm on the wrong sheet.
Plus two.
In my case, plus... You sure? For intelligence? Yeah, plus two.
Yeah, you've got a bonus, too.
Yeah, plus two.
4 damage.
Okay.
Attack. Target AC is 7.
You don't need AC. 14. You're just rolling damage.
Right,
you already hit.
Is 2.
It's just a D8 plus 2. I think you're using a macro or something. Just do it.
Yeah, I must be right.
Slash roll space 1D8 plus 2. Damage is... There's no macros for damage because it, you know, it varies a lot.
Fair enough.
Oh, unfortunate. Oh, but inspirational performance is still down? Is that correct? No. No, we have it now.
Yeah.
We have inspirational.
On the world map before. Do you really want me to use it for just this?
For a 1 on a possible 10 damage, and as soon as this encounter is over, it resets and you have it again.
Yeah.
All right, but
I mean, it's your choice. Your choice.
Anything else happens in this encounter, I can't let you reroll anything.
It's true, but that was a one.
Yeah.
On a big, big spell.
Fair enough then.
Don't forget to subtract your one mana point.
Yes.
Cathar.
You have been inspired to do it again. Roll your damage again.
Yep. You can freely reroll. Are you kidding me? Oh my god, I don't know what the hell was going on. Holy shit.
Okay, and Vor and Windar, you've got to shoot the bastard, so...
I've already shot
He missed, and we need damage from Vor. Yeah, you didn't roll damage yet.
Oh.
We're waiting, with bated breath. What is happening to us? What the hell is this?
Roll 20, it's on to us! Quick! Run away!
Does it even look vaguely wounded?
It's probably just laughing at us.
Yeah, it's moderately injured, but it's more pissed off at this point. Like, more than anything. It's pissed off.
Who is it most pissed at? Who's it going for? Can we tell yet? Okay, I guess initiative.
No. It's, yeah.
Oh, man.
Time for initiative.
I am so good at initiative, guys. I've been waiting for this moment. It's my time to shine. Oh, use the macro, guys, because you'll automatically be added to the turn order. That's a 6 for me. Let me make sure this is visible for the stream. There you go, guys. You can see what's going on. Try and frame this up nicely. Maybe I should zoom out. You guys would probably prefer to see that, right?
I wasn't added to the screen when I put attribute on.
Wasn't added?
My symbol's not on the turn order.
Oh, it's because you've rolled a attribute instead of initiative.
Oh god. I did.
Initiative is 1d8 modified by your dex, so I think it's a straight 1d8 for you. That is true.
What?
These ones, man, consistent ones. So many ones.
Okay.
Got 4, not too bad.
Plus one? Where the hell did it get that from? What? Has dex mods? This thing has dex mods.
It was actually more of a bonus that I granted it, it's just there was nothing there.
Okay, fair enough. On a tie, players act first, so luckily Vor actually gets some action in quickly there. Okay, well, I am first regardless of this being unordered right now, so what I intend to do at this point is move to here, it's the best I can do, and drop another smite onto the Barkheist, so that will be another saving throw for the Barkheist.
There we go, turn order's now sorted.
I cast smite on the Barkheist. Roll 1d20.
Okie dokie.
Oh. Well, that's a mana down. Sorry, guys.
I think it says successes, even though we failed.
Well, he's the Barkheist succeeded, at resisting the magic.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
That's a saving throw, yeah.
Okay, yeah, this Samir runs towards Azazel, screaming, grunting. She's like, "Wah,
wah, 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 wah."
I bolster.
Reaches back and swings this sort of like almost like tooth built sort of sword. It's like a wooden blade with teeth coming from it towards Azazel's face.
I have an AC of 2.
Good luck, Mr. Samir. Okay.
Can I fire at the Samir as it goes to attack?
Not in this game. Sorry.
You have to wait for your turn.
There's nothing like that here. So I absorb the blow, like bending my knees as I kind of crumple a little under the shield impact, and then I thrust its weapon back, like sort of, it doesn't fall or anything, but you know, I throw it off. Nice.
Okay, Kathar.
Well, am I in still magic range for the bad guys?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Right, well, yeah, I will do another magic if possible.
Okay.
So that's, I don't need to do initiative anymore, do I? It's just the straight damage.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, if it fails, it's saving throw.
I have to roll the save, yeah.
We'll see if it takes that 4 points. It does.
It does take those 4 points.
Nice. How does it look, by the way? How, when you, like, lightning hands or what?
Mention, I also get a stun with lightning bolt.
Oh, dude, we should have applied that. Oh, yeah, man. We still get to do that. Yeah, so the Barkheist is now stunned, and we'll make a saving throw next turn to see if it becomes unaffected, you know?
Yeah.
So it will be stunned up until it succeeds that. God damn, lightning is strong in this game. Who made that? Who wrote these spell tables? What the hell?
Okay, yeah, so it's the Bargeist's turn now, so I guess another saving throw.
Yeah, and if it resists, then it's, if it succeeds, it's all good to go. He's out of it, yeah.
Okay, Vor.
I'm going to attack the same here. What AC does it have?
So Samir have an AC of 7.
Okay.
Oh man, if you... I'm not even going to say it until after you've rolled. Yes. Oh, yes, nice.
Okay, roll for damage.
Respectable.
Yep. That's killed him. Describe your kill.
It's by the way, Kat, can I join in on the description?
Yeah, go for it.
Because I just pushed its weapon back, and like as it kind of stumbled backwards, then I gave you like a big opening to like headshot it or something. Kat, don't forget that as a hunter, you have a passive ability called Cold Shot, and just let me take this opportunity to explain, because you definitely should make use of it, and I'm sure you'll enjoy playing your class a lot more if you do.
It saved me a couple of times.
If you want to make a headshot, you'll gain a +1 to your damage rolls. If you aim for the torso, you'll gain a +1 to your hit roll or your attack roll. If you want to shoot at a thing's appendages or its weapon, you can potentially disarm it. And if you want to shoot at something's legs, you can potentially slow it. So each time you're firing, you have a decision, one of four options there.
Do I call that before I roll?
Before you roll, you'll choose exactly where you're aiming. Cool.
Okay.
I give you this grand opening. Beautiful.
My arrow whistles right underneath your armpit and straight through his eye socket, like exploding blood all over you.
That was super stylish. Like, I am impressed.
Okay, Windahl.
I'm going to stroll a bit more here to get a bit of a better view. Let's have a look. Ah, I think I can safely say. Right, I'm gonna try my luck again at that ugly bastard. What was it, Stacey, again?
The Bargeist has an AC of 6.
Bam! And then...
Okay, roll me your damage. Oh,
nice, wait. Dude.
Yeah, I'm going to do that, but then I'm going to... Okay. Yeah, deduct that. Okay. Also, we have a morale check that we missed right after Vore.
It's always the case. Wouldn't be a session of Call to Arms without missing the morale checks.
Exactly.
Morale checks.
I doubt these things could flee from us. We've got them pretty cornered here. I mean, if they run deeper into the cave, we'll pursue. I'm feeling confident. Wait, what did the Bargeist do on its turn?
It just came out of stun.
Why didn't it should have acted?
Didn't state that it could act at the same time. I just thought you, because you said like on its turn.
No, I said it was good to go. I said it's good to go now. Like it still has a movement and an action. The saving throws don't count as anything. It's like a separate thing.
Okay, yeah. So the this same ear flees.
I was a bit confused as to why it hadn't moved up towards me, and then I realized I should have been more clear. I think you should retcon the Bargeist's turn.
Yeah, I can do.
Yeah, because it would have acted as soon as it came out of that stun. I didn't catch it at the time, that's my bad.
Fair enough. Okay. Yeah, with ease, fair enough. Okay, so yeah, this Bargeist coming out of stun runs towards Azazel.
Brought this on myself.
Runs towards Azazel, teeth bearing, crushing down on him, and growls. It's just like, and jumps and pounces down on Azazel.
Good times.
Yeah.
It's a 2 AC.
An AC of 2.
How many attacks does this thing have? I'm wondering as I posture. Oh, I am a wall.
Yeah, so it came out of its stun and went to attack you. And I'm guessing it was still slightly stunned and just missed completely.
It's just been electrocuted. I mean, come on.
It's seeing like triple vision, and it like basically bit, tried to bite and claw at an apparition of you that wasn't really there.
So it just like slams its claws on both sides of me, and I'm just standing in between, like.
And yeah, this same ear is basically they're fleeing.
Okay, fair enough. As a free action, I'm definitely going to be like, Vore, take care of the escaping one. I don't know what it's called in character.
Can I make that shot?
Not right now, but I'm calling it out at this stage, yeah.
It's actually Azazel's turn next.
It is my turn. And of course, I take my short sword and slash across the creature's face.
Okay.
What's its AC?
6.
Attack. Target AC 6. Attack bonus 2. 0. Sorry. combat skill, 0. Attribute bonuses, 2. Penalty, nothing, and no bonuses at this stage. 25, I hit.
Okay.
1d6 damage. It's a pretty respectable hit. I guess I get it like across its face or something.
Yeah, you take a swipe out of it, it sort of shakes it off, blood spills out of its face, like just sort of pours out.
Nice. Yeah.
And it sort of looks at you and growls.
So I kind of like, as it sort of like writhes, I like shield myself from the spray of blood that, just imagine the contrast of the clean silver and the blood like splashing off the shield. Beautiful. Slow motion as well. And I'm done.
Cathar to go, yeah.
Cathar. It is your turn. Oh great, gnome wizard. I think his mic's muted. He muted, dude.
Sorry, dude. I was speaking to someone else.
Oh, my bad.
I really apologize. Very bad etiquette. I'm going to, of course, go into Thunderbolt Bargeist. I mean, I've got the mana to do so.
All right.
So...
no quarrels there. Okay. Oh, it resists. Oh. That stun would have been useful. It's on top of me at this point.
Okay, Bargeist to go.
Yeah.
Okay, so it shakes that blood off of its face, like clearing itself, growls, and then lunges forwards to you to take another attack.
It can't be pleased with me at this point. I've been slapping it about. Nice. Ping! I just kind of like my heels dig in and I slide back in the dirt as one claw whacks into my shield, and a second, and I dig even further into the ground as the second hit lands. Wow. Nice. The shield is... I just kiss it. I don't really. That would not be good in a combat scenario.
After it attacks you, it... it sort of jumps backwards, almost like pouncing back away from you, and then growls at you.
Okay.
Like you've pissed it off, basically. Like it's not sure what to make of you in particular. Like it's tried for like essentially 4 times. It's done nothing. It's just it's more flabbergasted than anything. The bewilderment in its eyes is just like, what the fuck?
What did I just run into? Like this never happens, man.
Okay, Vor, you'll go.
I fire at the same ear?
Pretty sure you'll still have the range to make that shot.
Yeah, I'm pretty positive.
I have. What's its AC? 7?
Yeah, 7. Yeah,
within, totally.
Oh, whilst I fire, I'm shout, coward!
Unfortunate miss.
Yeah, your arrow flies past his head, completely missing.
Don't forget to subtract the arrow still.
Oh yeah, I need to subtract 3.
Yeah. Windal, your go, my friend.
Well, of course, I think I'm going to try and... Oh, wait. Wait a second. It's running away. No, coward! Oh, well, of course, I'm going to try and shoot that bastard again.
Who were you shooting at? The same ear or Bargeist?
The big one.
Say the Bargeist. Okay, cool.
Just in case you're not quite familiar with the mechanics, Tom, your performance checks can grant bonuses in encounters, you know, like to attack rolls and what have you. Just as that's kind of like the support method of play.
I've already used my encounter.
No, sorry, not the skill, not the class skill. I mean the actual performance check, the skill check. So you can, like, if you want to play as, like, a support bard, you can grant +1s and +2s to people by performing along throughout the encounter.
Oh.
Just saying.
Right,
just throw... Okay, good to know. Good to know.
Well, I miss.
That's a miss, yeah.
I also believe that was very helpful once during the test campaign.
It saved the day. I believe in testing, in balance testing, we actually won an encounter thanks to a plus one granted by a bard, yeah. with a party of level one characters fighting something that was way, way out of their league. They should have never won. It was crazy.
Just to let you know, that's not in the player handbook.
It is. It is now. It's been added. Don't worry. It's under it's under assist
call
checks.
Call it a retcon.
Under assist checks, performance checks.
What? Not in special ability.
Your special ability allows someone to re-roll a failed attack, skill check, blah, blah, blah. Your performance check, the actual, like, the way it's implemented is you can perform to raise the party's morale and give us, anyone in earshot gains a bonus.
Is that limited to just bards?
It's any class, but bards are the only ones who can actually take performance as a class skill, so it's very hard for other classes.
So, in theory, if they wanted to, another class could have performance and gain...
And grant a bonus to someone, but it would be very, very difficult, yeah.
Okay, so this same ears continue fleeing and is sort of just ran into the darkness.
Okay. Well. Okay, once again, I am going to charge the beast. I just go running as fast as I can and then just drop my short sword onto it once more.
Okay.
AC of 6 there, attack bonus 2. Unfortunately missing.
Okay.
And I am here. Do I assume that I'm too far away now that it moved a little bit, or am I still...
You're fine.
I'm fine. Right, well, same again, obviously. Yeah. Oh!
That plus 3 though. That plus 2 pulling you through. No, it's not pulling you anywhere. Well, time for me to get wailed on a bit more, maybe. I did catch up with the thing. you might want to Cathar might want to step up 20 meters just if you are getting worried about it outranging you. Your range is 150. You can check it out with the measure tool.
Would I be able to do that after my turn?
Yeah, you
after
still had movement.
Failed magic.
Yeah, you still had a 2.
Yeah.
Sorry, 20 meter movement. What the hell was that? I think I just got crit, guys.
Yeah, natural 20.
Well, I've looked out on the second, but yeah, I just got crit. This is going to be bad.
So yeah, this beast sort of is annoyed that you've re-come back up in its grill and sort of lunges forward and goes to take a huge...
I imagine that it just, like, paws me against the wall or something. We'll see damage, but if damage is high, I just get, like, swiped across the space, slamming against a solid stone wall, blood out the mouth, like, just fall to the ground. I mean, I'm imagining the worst, as you can tell. I'm down. I just get exactly what I just said happens. I'm down. I'm bleeding through. I'm done. I'm gonna be about there, I'd say, and I'm done.
Yeah, after it throws Azazel out of the way, it just lets out, it bellows out a great howl which echoes throughout the cave, and then it sort of looks forward towards Cathar, Vor, and Windar's sort of area and just begins.
Thanks, dude.
Begins to walk forwards.
I am just a crippled heap. Oh.
Okay, Vor, it's your go.
I'm gonna shout for Azazel and fire at him.
Okay.
Is it 6?
Do I hear that as I sail into the afterlife?
Yeah, he's
she just saw her comrade die. Well, get mauled. She should get a plus one for shouting for Azazel.
Some GMs would grant that, but it's not necessary. As that is a clean hit.
Okay. Roll me damage, Lox.
Nice.
Oh, yeah, he's down. Finally, he's down. Describe your kill.
Oh man, I'm really fired up. I'm so angry about what's happened to Azazel that I fire my arrow and run forward a little bit. Just because I'm really angry.
Like, you run forward and lower your bow and then, like, square up your big shoulders and, like, look at it. Like,
oh, can I do a big, like, lynx roar at it?
Yeah, you could do a lynx roar at it. Of course.
Yeah, I roar at it. And puff all my fur out, like,
that's even better, dude.
Yeah, this bar guy stammers a little bit, sort of just sort of out of place, and then just rolls over and, you know, dies.
Well, I'm unconscious.
So...
okay, there we go. You're out of your first battle. Have a man down.
Dude.
Kinda literally too. He's not there.
Flames takes role playing very seriously.
Yes.
If he's dead, he goes.
He did.
I go over and poke his lifeless body.
I can't say help or not. Bandages, are they used for reviving people? Or is that not right?
It's treat injury. If he's dead, he's dead.
Yeah, fair enough.
I think he is grievously injured. I don't think he's dead.
Oh, right, well...
I'm not sure. I'll have to wait for him to get back, because I can try and flick through the book. He'll probably be back before
I...
Yeah.
Well, I have the bandage! Yeah!
But no. We don't.
Should have brought Washington. He's trained in healing.
But we left him 2 days ago.
How about instead of them using their turn to look through your backpack, can't I use telekinesis to just tip your backpack open?
You don't need... Yeah, the account's entered. It's free actions now.
Alright. Sound cool.
Yeah.
Cool.
Just the Bargeist hasn't been removed because, unlike humanoids, it does have valid... stuff to do with it.
Right. Very right. That's a valid explanation too. Yay! Honestly, I've seen error messages more like worse worded than that. We have said we're going to try and do, isn't it?
Wake up!
I mean...
Wake up, you bastard human! Don't die on me! I never lost a man yet! Susan, does anyone have an idea what to do?
Can I shout? I've got a high intelligence. Can I shout, look through his backpack?
I only deal with killing things, not saving things.
Well, I think I'll be the one to try. Let's see if I'm smart enough to look in the backpack. What kind of role is this going to be? Alright, the healing kit. Okay. Well, yeah, I take out your healing kit and attempt to do what's necessary.
You're going to have to roll.
Nah, I'm not. I'm
only you.
Yeah. After each day spent tending to an Indian advent. Two D6 plus one, nice.
Oh god. Well, it's stable. Shit, now we're gonna have to spend all day tending to this corpse.
You know, technically we should have let him die. It'd be easier.
Yeah, but the healer is vexed. We have to tend him back to health. Shit, I forgot you're a cleric. I think it's here for us.
Sorry.
Oh no. Oh god, does that mean you've only healed 1 HP? Two HP.
Can I root around in this bar guy's body, see if there's anything interesting?
Yep.
Nature check.
What do I do for nature check? Is it a skill check?
Slash 2d6, yeah. And you've got a plus 2 from your book. You look at the Bargeist. You look at the Bargeist, and you know from your vast hunting experience that Bargeists make good meat.
Tasty.
I'm down.
Can I skin him and chop his bits of meat off?
Yeah.
You can tell you've never done any hunting.
You start butchering it and whatnot, and you get 7 provisions out of it.
Nice.
Yeah.
In Doom, you could eat raw meat. What's this game all about, anyway?
Could I retrieve any of my spent bolts from the corpse? Pick up. I've rolled a 20 on a save.
A natural 20. Yeah.
I'm gonna say you recover 25% of your things. Yeah.
What the heck does that mean then? I only fired 3.
If you fired 3, then it would go up to the nearest thing, which would be 33%, so a bolt.
So a bolt.
You get a bolt back, yeah.
Yeah. That's believable. Bones, damn tough.
Yeah, yeah. Like you've just turned that corner as you've walked, and he's still running, still fleeing. He's sort of like basically cowered in a corner.
My danger beard, its ugly head.
I smite him. And...
I just smite him with his dastardly deed.
I shall roll that save for him. Cheers, I've selected the right token. There we go. Yeah, it has a lower magic save than what's it? Bargeist. Can I? Yeah, you can. You can run up there. No, he's running back. He's sort of, well, I say running. He started running. He's now sort of like, sort of cowering in like what he thought was like this nice darkish sort of cave, and he's slowly edging his way along the wall side down away from you all. Yeah. No, it's not long run. It would, it, yeah. I'm not too sure what his athletics would be. Why have I got that still selected? Yeah, I think so. That's a pretty safe intro. Yeah.
I'll follow in tow. La 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 la.
Whoops, a daisy. There we go. So this creature that is here, this is in a cage. Okay, so I'll pull up the things. This is a new creature. Okay, so a Grongast. Again, I'll read it out aloud so it saves some people struggle to read this sort of handwriting type thing as well. And yeah. So yeah. After my years of traveling, not much scares me, but a Bargeist-like creature with wings, horns, and an insatiable lust for flesh instills fear even in this adventurer. They fly much like birds in packs and attack livestock on farms. I took many jobs protecting farmland from repeat attacks from these things, Grongasts are about the size of a horse and have huge bat-like wings and the horns of a bull and the poison-tipped tail, much like a common scorpion. A truly hideous, despicable creation. The horns make good drinking vessels, though, I must say.
Well, I have heard of Arcana check. I was going to say, I have heard of such a beast, but I will have to check my notes from university and then do the Arcana check for my notes. But if you tell me how to do the Arcana check, I'll just roll it. Oh, that's what I meant. To find out if I know anything about it, I'd have to look through my old university notebooks, which he's a gnome, he could probably carry on him. Yeah. And if you read the little bit of, like, religion law that was written, I can see him carrying his notebooks, couldn't you?
Yeah.
So, you tell me what to roll, and I'll roll it. 2d6?
Yeah, so, in your text book, you read that the Grongast is seen as almost like the god of wolves. The Bargeist is the king, wolves are regular, and the Grongast is seen as almost like the god of wolves. And they, when they're around, wolves and Bargeists flock to them uncontrollably. Like, they're almost in their own trance-like state and head to them.
Yes.
Quite interpretation.
It did not seem that way to me. It seemed that if we let this creature go, it may take the others with it. Without killing us, but I doubt I'll pass that saving throw. So, I think... Well, I was suggesting that may be a possibility, but it would be safer with your way. So I have heard, mighty warrior, cleric. You're mighty to me if you're taller than me, so that's all of this party. I don't think my quarterstaff's going to do much damage at once.
No, I mean, your spell casting.
Oh, the spell cast is definitely going to work. That's why I said I've got no disagreement there, but... But I'd say not to kill it. I'd say we kill all the ones outside first. And then just leave it there, maybe. Depends. Can we look at how strong the cage is? Right, fair enough. Mm-hmm.
But okay, I panically seen the orb.
Okay, yeah, the this same ear that's just here is taunting the Grongast and poking it and laughing. The Grongast is looking really distressed and but also very angry. Yeah, the cage is locked via a large padlock. Like a large metal cage.
I don't change things then. No. I have a better idea after having studied magic. Were I to use my telekinesis to lift the key off the jailer's keychain, but it's a padlock. Oh, well, I don't know.
There's no keys on these two.
Okay, well, yeah, we'll try using a Thunderbolt. Sometimes it's enough to break it, sometimes it fuses it shut forever. We shall see.
I'll shoot at it. I can make that shot.
I'm willing to let. Yep.
Will there be any AC on a lock?
God, it's going to have a higher AC than I will, for Christ's sake.
If this was the Twisted Halls of Valcutta, it's a possibility that it would be sentient. God, we're not in that acid trip. Yeah, it sort of bounces off of the off of this lock.
Yeah, why not? I'll true shot. Let's do it.
Yeah. Ding.
Well, I can't see anything that actually tells me the strength of a lock in terms of how much damage it can withstand.
I have 5 hit points.
Yeah.
Cave-like environments are often down.
It's definitely not rusted or aged to keep a Grongast in. It's damaged. Like, it's heavily damaged, but it's not broken.
Oh, come on!
Sorry.
I'm chucking my bow on the floor in a strop now.
Yes, it is.
Screw you guys! I'm turning my mic up.
Go home.
Well.
Okay.
What do you reckon if we shot at just the simian creatures, it might pacify the wolf-like creatures?
No.
Okay.
I mean, it... Then maybe they would...
No, the Grongast is like basically worshipped by the Bargeists and the wolves, whereas the Bargeist is only worshipped by the wolves. It's basically the king of wolves is the Bargeist, but the Grongast, the one in the cage, is like a god of wolves. Like, it's a huge, huge wolf. Yeah, it's... Well, from the you'd know that in your journal the Grongast has an insatiable appetite for flesh. Yeah.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Score.
Well,
come on.
Yeah. Come on. Okay. Yeah. The lock to this cage is split in two. This same ear literally shits himself. Like literally, like. There, he is absolutely terrified. There is actual defecation going on.
It's like, what the fuck?
Bear with me one moment.
It's gonna be mad.
Let's just hope it just doesn't go on a rampage. No, and I mean, take us out in the rampage.
It rams. It rams the cage door and sends this same ear who was just shitting himself flying, and just walks out, and then lets out this almighty howl, just this absolutely ludicrous howl. Yeah, I'll organize that now. I've got to add this Grongast to the turn order now. Yeah, it's because he was in the cage, so he wouldn't have had a turn being in the cage, but now he has one. So on him. Wow. Yeah, pretty much. Okay, I'll organize this turn order. Ta-da.
Even though I did higher than last time, I'm still among the last to go.
No, because you got the same... You got the... Because it's the same as the same year, you still go before the same year, so...
Ooh, nice.
That's a Bargeist. No, he will defend them. They will defend each other. But now that he's free, they might not necessarily be very nice to the same ear, so... Okay, Vor?
I've just been. Has it not someone else?
All right, have you just been?
I went before.
All right, sorry, okay. So yeah, this Bargeist, the Grongast has come out of the cage and it lets out this almighty roar and its wings spread out and unfurl and it's almost like crinkling sound, like it's not happened for a while. And this Bargeist just looks towards this Grongast with love and starts walking towards it, and this same ear that's in the way, it gets attacked. So let me just move these forward. Six. Okay, that's one. Oh wait, no, that was the wrong AC, wasn't it? Shit. It would have still failed, but yeah, that was the AC for them, not the same here. Wow, okay. Yeah, it missed with its jaw as it lunged forward, but then just claws down on this same ear and just piles his skull into the ground, and that same ear is dust. Yeah. oh yeah. Yeah. You could attempt it, sure.
I pick up my bow that I buggered about with. I guess I'm gonna follow you.
Sorry, am I gonna be quick enough to keep up with you? Yeah.
It'll be my pleasure.
Yeah. Yeah, you take a minus one for carrion. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, you managed to make it 30 meters, which puts you both there.
Please tell me that was not an athletics check. Oh, well, on my own, I have a level in it. Could I have not used that on my own and increased your own chances? For next time. I think we should keep it this way this time, but for next time, because we didn't think of it this time, we should be penalized.
Yeah, for the interest of keeping the pace up, I'm not going to allow it to be retconned, but yeah, just bear in mind for next time, for sure, as it will be beneficial.
Yeah. I know. I literally only just checked it afterwards to check athletics. Oh, it might help. Shit. It fucking would have done.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Everybody, reroll initiatives. After this Bargeist, just decimated that one Samir, the Grongast walked over to the Bargeist and just nuzzled it with its nose, like soothing this poor Bargeist. The other Samir is basically at this point trying to flee. Like, he's got no choice. He's wanting to go this way. He's not even caring. I don't think you'd be able to tell whether that would aid you. No. I mean, their focus seems to be on this same year still, so.
Cool. But we'll do it separately. Yeah, we're run past.
Yeah, you can just try and run past, yeah.
But it was a learning chance for not picking me up, no matter how much I demand it.
Okay, so you flee past the Bargeist and the Grongast and the Samir. And as you're sort of like, your backs are turned, you just hear the screams of this one Samir, like, being absolutely, like, he's been eaten. He's clearly been eaten. Like, behind you, they're destroying him.
Oh, it sounds like it's been much done.
Okay, yeah, the screams echo throughout this, like, cave network, basically, of this poor Samia bastard being eaten alive, and the howl of this Grongast and Bargeist. And...
Always.
And these two Samia that are down here are alerted by that sound, and they have began to walk upwards from the darkness behind.
Oh, flipping heck.
Yeah.
Hey guys, I don't mean to be a piper, but I'm gonna have to leave because it's literally gonna be 9 o'clock now, nearly 9:20 because of the way the clocks go forward. So, I don't mind you guys carrying on without me, but I'm gonna have to scoot. Okay.
Okay.
Hey, no problems. Sorry for leaving early. I'll be able to stay longer next week because I'm not working on Monday. Right, I'll catch you guys later.
No, catch you later.
Bye. Bye.